The Amazing Eye Anatom by Dr. Anwar Hamdi. All the animations and illustrations were accomplished to the actual scale after meticulous computations to the trustworthy data. Our planet Earth is composed of seven layers, the crust with a thickness of 40 kilometers, the upper mantle with a thickness of 360 kilometers, the transition region with a thickness of 250 kilometers, the lower mantle with a thickness of 2050 kilometers, the D layer with a thickness of 190 kilometers, the outer core with a thickness of 2260 kilometers, and the inner core of a thickness of 1228 km. If we represent the Earth as a ball of 10 centimeters radius, then the crust will be this thin rim. But even then, this thin rim is equal in weight to 10 trillion Q food pyramids. And from this crust, we are able to build 600 billion iron pyramids like Khufus. Even more, from the core, we are able to build 320 trillion iron pyramids like Khufus. Counting 1,000 pyramids per second, we will need more than 100 centuries to count them. Earth has a magnetic field because its solid iron core is surrounded by a fluid ocean of hot, liquid metal. The flow of liquid iron in Earth's core creates electric currents, which in turn create the magnetic field. The Earth's magnetic field is extremely important for protecting the planet from so-called solar wind. The solar wind is a stream of ionized gases that blows outward from the sun at about 400 kilometers per second, and that varies in intensity with the amount of surface activity on the sun. The magnetosphere, which is driven by the Earth's magnetic field, serves as a kind of electromagnetic barrier to prevent dangerous rays from reaching the surface of the planet. In this very small drop of blood, you have about 5 million red blood cells. These red blood cells are very small that you can arrange 82,000 of them on the base of your pin. Every red blood cell contains a huge number of hemoglobin molecules. Counting these molecules in one red cell at a speed of 60 per minute will take you about 9 years. There are several other transition metals comparable to iron which can replace it in hemoglobin and also bind O2, but this binding is either too strong or too weak. Thus, there are no non-iron analogues of hemoglobin having the required properties of normal hemoglobin for transporting O2 in blood. No substitute for oxygen exists which is similarly utilized in life processes. In every hemoglobin molecule there are 4 molecules of heme. These heme molecules are extremely small, so that you can arrange 1 million of them on the upper surface of a red blood cell, as well as 1 more million on the other surface. Solar wind hits Earth like a fire hose. The Earth is largely protected from the solar wind by its magnetic field, which deflects most of the charged particles. These particles would strip away the ozone layer, which protects the Earth from harmful ultraviolet rays. Oxygen is the element most vital to sustaining human life, more essential than food or water. Every cell in the body needs oxygen to complete the metabolic processes that give life and energy to every one of us. Oxygen transported to every cell by binding to iron and only iron. The only place capable of producing iron is nova. The only place able to force out iron is supernova. Then, the only one who is able to say that we sent down iron is the one who has the ultimate power to heat the nova and to control the explosion of the supernova. Iron, through its magnetic field, gives the planet Earth the ability to sustain life. Iron, by carrying oxygen, grants life to all living things on Earth. Consequently, doesn't iron have mighty power and many benefits for mankind? All the animations and illustrations were accomplished to the actual scale after meticulous computations to the trustworthy data. Thank you so much.